times the space that measures day and night to mortal men. He and his horrid crew laid vanquished rolling in the fiery gulf, confound though immortal, but his doom reserved him for more wrath. For now the thought of lost happiness and lasting pain torment him. Round he throws his baleful eyes that witness huge affliction and dismay, mixed with obdurate pride and steadfast hate. As far as angels can, he views the dismal situation waste and wild, a dungeon horrible on all sides round, as one great furnace flamed. Yet in those flames no light, but rather darkness visible, only to discover sights of woe, reasons of sorrow, doleful shades where peace and rest can never dwell. Hope never comes that comes to all, but torture without end still urges, and a fiery deluge fed with ever-burning sulfur unconsumed. Such place eternal justice hath prepared for those rebellious. Here their prison ordained in utter darkness, and their portion set as far removed from God and light of heaven as from the center thrice to the utmost pole. Whence they fell. There the companions of his fall, o'erwhelmed with floods and whirlwinds of tempestuous fire. He soon discerns a weltering by his side, one next himself in power, and next in crime, long after known to Palestine, and named Beelzebub, to whom the arch enemy and thence in heaven called Satan, with bold words breaking the horrid silence, thus began!
If thou beest he, know how fallen, how changed from him, who in the happy realms of light, clothed with transcendent brightness, did outshine myriads though bright. If he, whom you to lead, lighted thoughts and counsels, equal hope and hazard, the glorious enterprise, joined with me once, now misery hath joined in equal ruin. Into what pit thou seest, from what height fallen, so much the stronger proved he with his thunder. Until then, who knew the force of those dire arms?
Yeah.